Hello, 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 and welcome to, I think it might be episode 110. I didn't make a note of it, and I'm on the sofa. My computer's in the other room. But yeah, if you haven't read the description, I shall be babbling on about this here little doozy, John Anderson's Elias of Sun Hillow. And on the sofa today, I'm accompanied by my furry friend, Alex the Wonder Dog. Hello, Alex. Do you want to say hello to everybody? No. There you can see that I need a new sofa. Oops. That's because I spent all my money on prog rock records. But yeah, where were we? We'll talk about this. Oh boy, I got this a long time ago. I could have only been about 17 or 18. Bought it in Camden Town at second-hand record shops with the missus. She weren't the missus then. She was just known as the girlfriend. That's before she earned a promotion. And yeah, I mean, this record, this was recorded back in the days, 1976, same year as Patrick Mraz's Story of Whatever. And as if you haven't been following these, after Yes recorded Relayer, they were kind of instructed to go off and record solo albums. And so you had Patrick Mraz, John Anderson, Steve Howe and Chris Squire. Still got to check out about them. Like, they all released albums, solo albums at the same time, or roughly the same period. And I'm going to be looking at these records and blabbering on about them as usual. But yeah, this is John Anderson's. It's not a Roger Dean cover, funny enough. It's by, what's his name, he said, Dave Rowe. And yeah, I mean, you'll see the cover because I'll do a little interlude where it's a lovely gatefold, the original LP, and it comes with like a little comic-y book or graphic novella. I don't know what you call it. It's only a few pages. But it tells the story of this old wizard and in his ship, the Morglade. And there's all these strange words. It's a bit like J.R. Tolkien, but on the mushrooms. But yeah, I mean, legend has it that John Anderson's supposed to record this on his own. There's been some debate over the years whether he did or didn't. Now, I think he did because it's got such a homespun sound to it. And if you listen to, this is what I really like about this record is the production. Because you do get the feeling it was recorded in a shed. And I don't mean that in a bad way. I mean that in a cosy, do it all yourself kind of way. I hate to be proven wrong that maybe he did get Vangelis to help him. But if you listen to the way the synths and the guitars are played, John Anderson's a very limited player. I don't mean that in a bad way. He's like me. He has limited abilities and he uses them the best he can. And so we tend to use similar riffs and motifs and reuse them. And he does that with Elias of Sun Hillow. If you hear his other recordings or if you see him play live, he has a certain style of playing. And it's very evident on this record. So I do believe that he recorded the whole thing himself. It's a concept album. It's about a wizard, I think, and a ship, and him doing stuff on this ship. It's just absolutely gloriously bonkers. In only a way that John Anderson, again, this is the only John Anderson album you need, because it is just absolutely brilliant. It really is. It really is a good record, and it's got drama and peaks and troughs, and you know, it really goes up and down, and there's a real good kind of ambient feel to it. You know, you do get the feeling he's making almost a soundtrack to a movie. I find it very cinematic. Yeah, I mean, the only thing it lacks is like guitar playing and you know, proper guitar or keyboard solos. But that's not what it's about. It's not a Yes album. It's a John Anderson album, and it's a pure John Anderson album. And unfortunately, and I say that with a heavy heart, he is rumoured to be working on a sequel, and I hope he doesn't complete it because it won't be nowhere near as good as this recording. So yeah, I mean, it's one of those records. It's hard to go into detail because it's very cinematic. It's very much a journey. You bathe in it. You know, you put the headphones on or you put it on the on the record player, and you let it swirl around you. It's very swirly, and it is very in place. It is a bit reminiscent of Vangelis too. Heaven and Hell. I should probably talk about that one because John Anderson guests on that, and they're kind of very stylistically similar. Now I'm beginning to think maybe Vangelis did have a hand in this. But yeah, it's a really good record, and I think you should check it out. I haven't got the CD version of it, but I did buy the iTunes version, and the sound quality is, you know, it's okay. But I mean, it will never beat the original LP with its, I'm fondling it now, the LP, I tell you, with its original kind of textured cover and its illustrations. Very much a thing of its time, you know, and you kind of miss those old days when, you know, when musicians could get away with doing pretentious stuff like this. And look, he's even got a little cartoon of him with his family, look. Isn't that good? But yeah, oh, I really like Eliza Sunhillo. It's got a soft spot. Again, there are albums that you go, oh, it's a bit like The Story of I look at that and go, oh, and the same with this one, oh, because, you know, you have a real fondness from it. They might not be great masterworks, but, and they might be flawed, but, you know, they're like an old pair of trainers, he said, pulling up his old trainer. Even though he's got a new trainer, he wears his old ones because they're more comfortable. Absolutely. But yeah, so there you go. I think I've just... I'm trying to record this as well, so you get my voice a bit better. I think I just banged the microphone with my elbow. Oh, the professionalism. So yeah. An absolute 5-star recommendation in terms of a rating. So it's 5 Morglades out of 5. That's 5 Morglades out of 5. And here's a little bit of trivia. Now, I'm a big fan of a movie called The Squeeze, starring American actor Stacy Keach. I love that guy. He's just, he don't see him around that much these days. And there's a snippet of Eliza Sunhillo at the end, towards the end of it. Now, I remember seeing that film. Well, I'd seen the film when I was a kid, and because it's kind of a very gritty London gangster movie, and then I saw it after getting this album, and I watched it again, and I heard this bit. There's a Eliza Sunhillo in it, and for all you Brits out there, it also stars Freddie Starr in his only proper acting performance, and he's really good in it. So you should check out that The Squeeze. It's from a bygone age, you know, when we used to make gritty movies. But yeah, Eliza Sunhillo on the soundtrack. Who'd have thunk it, eh? So that's it, really. My name's been, Darren Locke, and I've been doing my best to explain the mystery that is Eliza Sunhillo and why I like it so much. And that's it. So, only one more thing to say. Are you ready?